Hey, it's Trigger, Rich Bontrager. Recently, I was interviewed by some individuals, and they kept coming back to this word picture, this theme, that they put my life into. You're like a boxer who's in the boxing ring of life, and you keep getting smacked and smacked, and you go down, you're on the rope, but somehow you keep standing back up and doing it again. And they said, they asked, what makes you so resilient? So here's the three things that helped me in my life to bounce back, to defy the odds and be resilient each and every day. Faith, hope, and love. Those are the three anchors, the three legs of the stool to help hold me up and keep me going every day. I have great faith. I have a great faith in God. My faith spiritually is very strong, and it's a part of my everyday routine in life. It's not faith that is mundane and boring. It's vital and vibrant. I have faith in a brighter tomorrow. I am the eternal optimist. My cup is always full to overflowing with, we can do it. Don't worry, we'll find a solution. There's hope for tomorrow. I believe in a brighter tomorrow, no matter what I'm facing today. I have great faith. I have great hope. These two are tied together. Hope is like gasoline in my soul. Hope comes that there can't be a no. I don't believe in the no-win scenario. Going all the way back to Star Trek, the Wrath of Khan. I know I'm geeking out a little bit, but that's okay. I do not believe in the no-win scenario. There is always a way to get back up and go again. This hope drives me on. Recently, I was knocked down again. I had great opportunities before me, and some things changed. So I am back to that hope. The next phone call, the next email, the next blog, the next Facebook, the next whatever. I believe there's more hope in tomorrow than there is today. So this fuel keeps driving me on to go on and go on and on. One way to change this idea of lack of hope: we've gone to a dark place in our world and our society. We spend more time on the negative than we do on the good. Twitter, Instagram, Pinterest, all these places are blowing up with so much negativity. So let me encourage you. It's really simple. Look on all your social media for the good, fulfilling, healthy stories. People that have been resilient. Lives that have been turned around and touched. That unsung hero that rose up, whatever it is, look for those hopeful stories, repost them, share them, focus on them. Look for the hope, look for the light out there and not all the darkness. It's easy to see the darkness. We overlook the great and goodness and the hope that is going on around us. I believe in the next generation leaders. I believe that there's great stuff in our young youth. In college, young adults. So many people are down on the next generation. They're all messed up. I don't believe that. I believe there are great dreams, aspirations, goals. There's so much goodness out there. We need to pour into them to help them unlock these amazing things and bring greatness to the table again for us. Love is the third and final one that helps me be resilient. Years ago, a gentleman by the name of Erwin McManus wrote this phrase, and it has stuck with me forever. I love to live, and I live to love. Think about this for a second. This is really powerful. I love to live, and I live to love. Think if we had that attitude across the board. I love to live. No matter where I'm at every day, even when I was in the darkest place of my liver failure before my transplant, I love to live. I believe every day was going to be a new adventure. I love to get up and I love to go. I love to live. I love the hike in the mountains of Colorado where I live now. I love to meet new people. I love to share the defying the odds stories. I love to live and I live to love. You see, I believe the more we love and pour out of us, the more we give our love away and shower it on people of all walks of life, the more that love will come back to us in different ways. It may not be in that moment. It may not be from that person. But I believe in the cycle of love that comes back. I love to live, and I live to love. So let me ask you, what helps you to be resilient? What helps you to bounce back? What are the key things that help to make you never say die and defy the odds? I would love to hear from you. Give me a like, give me a share, give me a comment. Give me a question down below on resilience. Just how resilient are you today? Hey, I'm the Trigger, Rich Bontrager. God bless. Have a great day.